Our topic is Achieve Automation with Quick Sets. We're going to start out by identifying how we access our Quick Sets, what are Quick Sets, and then we're also going to get into Job Editor. In version 12, we have some features that work and interact with Quick Sets. It's very interesting, so we're going to take a look at those scenarios right now. So we'll start out by talking about accessing our Quick Sets. So in the top of our screen, we have a button that says Edit Quick Sets, and when we click on that, it just opens up the menu simply to edit the Quick Sets. Now, at this point, we're able to select on the printer and see for each of these different printer models I have active, I can investigate and see what Quick Sets are available. All I really can do here is edit a Quick Set. I can't create new, I can't delete, I can't import or export. So I just wanted to show you as a fast way of getting into the Quick Sets to explore what the conditions are, possibly make an alteration. We can do that in Edit Quick Sets. I'll close that out. The main program for editing a Quick Set and going into all the functionality of Quick Sets would be to first select the printer that you want to explore the Quick Sets for. Every printer has its own series of Quick Sets. And then we're going to click on Configure Printer. Now we see a message that tells us server will shut down. So again, this is going to stop our processing. I'm not ripping or printing, so I will say yes. And now we see in our Configure Printer menu, the first tab is the Quick Sets. When you are first installed with the RIP software, you're always going to have a default Quick Set. This default Quick Set, as you'll notice, cannot be deleted, and if I edit the default Quick Set, we cannot rename it. So there's always going to be a default Quick Set. In addition to this, we can create new Quick Sets or copy Quick Sets. We can back them up by exporting them out or import new Quick Sets. So this is the full functionality menu for the Quick Sets. Now, what is a Quick Set? Well, I'm going to highlight this Quick Set and go into Edit. The Quick Set is going to control the parameters, the conditions, the functions of how the file is going to rip. When we rip a file, we're ripping it with a Quick Set, and that's a set of instructions by which the file is going to process. We've got a lot of controls in here, and the idea would be to create Quick Sets that are going to perform tasks so that you don't have to do these things manually later in Job Editor. Let the Quick Set handle or address the control, the setting. So let's take a look. I'm going to go ahead and cancel out of here, and I'm just going to say new to make a new Quick Set. So instead of editing the default, I'm just going to create a new Quick Set. At the very top, we could give this Quick Set a name. Right below that, we see the list for media, and the checkbox is on by default. Give media and page size from printer. The concept here is an operator's daily functionality would be to load the media on the printer, tell our software here in the upper right corner, tell our software what is the current and media and page size that we just loaded on the printer, and then rip files specifically for that media. However, we don't necessarily have to do that. We can uncheck that box and have a Quick Set for some other type of material. So I'm going to go into a durable backlit film, normal quality. I'm going to go here and I'm going to name this what we see there. Okay, so we would identify that Quick Set for that particular media. Now we can be very specific to have a Quick Set process to a certain media type. So I'm going to click OK, OK again, and now let's talk about using that Quick Set. So at the time I go to rip a file, open, I can make my selection, and here in my Quick Sets, I would choose that. Now I'm going to purposely go through and process this, backlit film. What I currently have loaded is a banner, a vinyl banner material. This file is being ripped with a Quick Set that is identifying to process for a backlit film, right? So it's very specific. And now we see the messaging, media mismatch, waiting for media. So this particular file will not print until we change our material. So now I would go to my printer, you know, load up my material, come in here, make that selection. And when I click OK, this messaging for the status updates and it says waiting to print because now the match of the media is on that particular to our software. We're telling it to load for that material. So that's kind of the situation we can process in this respect. I'll go back in here and change it back. So the nice thing about this is if we are processing files at random, meaning I'm not just going to process jobs for my banner vinyl. I want to bring in all my jobs, however it's going to be for later prints, for now, for however. I can have a quick set. I'll go back into Configure Printer for my main quick set window. I can have a quick set that is going to identify to a specific media. I can rip the file for that, but the file will be here waiting until the status changes to match up with that media type. So that's kind of a nice way of controlling things. We could have other quick sets to perform other tasks. So perhaps we want to scale and have a certain scale setting provided all the time, or anamorphically distort something, or rotate. Maybe we want to tell it a certain number of copies. You have an account that needs to print so many copies. So all these different settings are the controls of how we can process a file. When we're working with multi-page PDFs, a PDF that's made up of multiple pages, we can check on the box, submit pages as individual jobs. And then when that file rips with this quick set condition turned on, we will see every single individual job of those individual pages in that multi-page PDF. It's going to keep the naming convention. So if it was called Bridge, we would see P1, P2, P3, P4 for the individual pages. It would break that apart as a revision, if you will. And so that's something that can also be enabled. Other settings we have in our quick set is if we're working with cutter data, we can create a new quick set that's specific to a cutter model. So when I change my condition for my cutter to from none, and I grab a specific cutter model brand, and you can see here we've got a variety of different manufacturers. I'll go with GraphTech. At this point now, I'll name the quick set accordingly. And now that is going to be a quick set for my GraphTech cutter. The checkbox is on for use cutter path prefix. So in our file preparation, I would make a spot color that represents the cutter path. And I would name that spot color as a prefix beginning with cut contour. All one word, capital C, capital C. Processing that file with this quick set, because I'm identifying a cutter, it's going to isolate that cut contour spot color and not print it, but push it into my GraphTech cutter in cut server software. And we've got another class on cut server that's going to take place that will go into all the attributes with setting up for cutter. So we'll be discussing that in another presentation. So I'm going to click OK and create that for my GraphTech cutter. Again, you might have multiple cutters. You can go into new and make another one for a different cutter model and so forth, name it accordingly and keep it all set. So the specifics that we have in our quick set, the idea behind this is to keep ourselves to process something as fast and efficient as possible, avoid us from having to go and make these changes manually each time. It's going to eliminate some extra steps and apply some automation by performing tasks for us automatically. Oh, yep, sure, go ahead, sure.
Sorry. The option at the top, get median of page size and printer?
Yes.
If you have that enabled and you're not specifying a specific media type on the group, right? If you drop any file in, it'll just print on the media that's installed.
If this is enabled, it's going to use whatever is installed, yes. Whatever we have loaded on our printer, yes. Right now it reflects the banner. Yeah, it reflects the banner. And another good point to raise here is if we have multiple modes, in some cases, our printer drivers' media profiles contain multiple modes to them. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. This one just has one mode. But in some cases we have multiple mode settings. It's in the quick set, that we would specify the mode. So keep that in mind too. If we had, you know, 300 and 600 and so forth, we would be able to make those changes here in the quick set. That's where you actually designate, select the mode. So if I switch over and change my media and then go back into my quick sets, this menu here where it's grayed out, it would show that new media choice of what's loaded. So this is always going to reflect what's loaded. So I think, is that what you were asking? All right, very good, very good.
Thank you.
No problem. So we've got in our main setting here, our main menu, we also have an advanced button in the lower left corner. Now I'm going to pull this over a little bit just to show these side by side. When I go into advanced, there may be some settings we see here that are also in the main menu, but they're interactive. They work back and forth. So if it's active in the main screen, if it's active in this advanced button window, it's going to work throughout the software. So few conditions we have here, crop. I mean, I can enable cropping. And if I knew what my dimensions were, I could preset a crop for an image. Chances are this is something that's going to be done manually in Job Editor, but it's possible. It's one of the features we have. If you have our textile edition portion of the software, you are able to enable colorways, which are different color libraries, and you can select and browse and now have a quick set that's going to associate different color definitions for the textile files, which are index TIFFs. So this is another feature that we can work with in our quick sets. In our tiling category here, we've got tile setup. We can literally have a quick set where tiling is enabled automatically. And if you knew, maybe for some standardization in your company, you're always working with a certain size tile panel, you can come in here and specify what the default size should be. Same with the marks. We can indicate what type of tiling marks we want to have active. So all these things can be part of a quick set. We get into this color correction. So in Job Editor, we can go into our color correction tab, and we can apply some type of color correction and save it out, export it out in our color correction manager, our filter manager. We can export it out as a filter and then browse for it and import it here and then use that color correction filter here. So we're going to be having a conversation with Job Editor in another series, another class. And when we do that, we're going to be getting into the color correction filter because that's a function within Job Editor. Then we have our finishing section. And here we have bleed, so we can enable the bleed control, set our amount, set the bleed type. We can come in here and set an additional white space trim box and any of the marks we want to add, you know, setting in here, we can control all that. We have grommets. We can come in here and specify what the grommet amount should be, you know, where we want to place them, top, bottom, left, right. We can have all of these different controls. Marks, this is where we have our overall marks for our file. So if you want to have registration marks, if you want to have crop marks, if you want to have a crop outline, if you want to enable a label that will print along the bottom of your file, in setup, we can type in a user comment, which would be static at this point in a quick set. We can turn on or enable any of our job ticketing information. We can see this other information for printing the file name and the job name and so forth. So we can enable or disable what parts of these settings do we want to include in that label. So if we enable a label.
Can you define what a bleed is?
Yes, back here in finishing bleed?
Yep.
Yes, absolutely. So in some cases, we'll have an image file and they want to extend on the left, right, top, bottom. They want to extend out that image. Now that bleed, let's say it's going to be a 1-inch bleed overall. We could break the link and do, you know, just different dimensions here, what have you, and zeros and so forth. But if we're going to do like a canvas wrap, I can have a 1-inch overall bleed, and then what type of bleed I want. If I choose mirror, my image, let's say my image size is 10 inches wide by 8 inches tall. With a 1-inch bleed mirror, I'm going to have a 1-inch left and right, so my 10 inches is actually going to be 12 inches. That additional inch on the left and on the right will be a mirror image. It literally starts to print in that bleed area a mirrored reflection of the main edge of that image. And I can show you this in Job Editor. I'm planning on doing that, so we'll come into this again. So the bleed is, in this case, taking either a mirror of the image, or duplication takes the very edge pixel property and repeats it in that 1-inch bleed, top, bottom, left, right. Or color is going to be where we can specify white or first pixel, and within the software of Job Editor, we can identify a recipe of what we want that color composition to be. So we can type in a CMYK value or an RGB value, so we can put in the information for that. So in these cases, we're thinking of bleed as taking our image or a color or a pixel and filling in a certain amount, in this case 1 inch, top, bottom, left, right, beyond the image size going outward. And for a canvas wrap, that's perfect, because we want to be able to have the center of the image, 10 wide, 8 tall, fit the frame, but then around the 1-inch sides being pulled will be that bleed image, and then maybe the backing, and then we just staple it or glue it or however we adhere for our canvas wrap. And there's different kinds of, you know, methods and types of frames and so on and so forth. So bleed is just an extension of the image. And how are we extending that image? Or an extension of color, additional color coming out. So I will show you this in Job Editor. So we're definitely going to revisit this. And getting the visual in Job Editor will also help you to see it compared to what we're talking about here in the quick sets. So I'm going to definitely, I'll definitely.
Can I assume that trim box is just the opposite?
Well, trim box is additional white media space, blank, non-printing, additional media space from this 1-inch bleed. So if I have a 1-inch bleed, and that's going to be in a canvas wrap, that's going to be the sides of the wooden frame, I might want an additional 1 inch to go along the back. That's going to be kind of like against the wall, and that might be where I glue it. Or maybe I want it along the back and tucked inside the wooden frame. I might tell this 2 inches, and then I get an additional 2 inch beyond the 1-inch bleed, additional media out there that I would cut down, trim down, because I put my marks on here, top, bottom, left, right, cut that out. Or some people like to use these other choices. We have a banner and we have a frame, but we can put marks on there where we know where to cut to, and then we would position on our frame, and then pull the media back and kind of do the turn, and then staple or glue that material. Or like I said, some frames have like a inner frame that you kind of press, you tuck it into like a fold. So trim is additional media beyond the bleed. The bleed is beyond the image. And like I said, we'll definitely take a look at this in Job Editor. When you see a visual, it totally helps you understand a little bit more too. So we'll take a look at that in Job Editor.
Thank you.
Sure. All right, so we've got the bleed controls. If we're doing something like with banners and grommets, we can control the placement. And again, I'll show you this in Job Editor. You'll get a better view of it, a visual view. And then the marks, whatever types of marks you want to have. And again, we'll take a look at this into our Job Editor programs to get the visual of it. So we can control in a quick set. The nice thing is, I might say, yeah, you know, I do need a canvas wrap. I do need one for banner and grommets. So that's two different quick sets right there that we can create. So I can come in here, and I can say, enable my bleed. I want a 1-inch bleed, a 2-inch trim box. I'll click OK. That'll be my quick set, and I'll call this full canvas wrap, if that's what they call it, however they refer to it. Full canvas wrap. I'll click OK. Go back into new, the advanced button, grommets. I might want to turn on top and bottom grommet. I can control by spacing, so every 12 inches or quantity. I need a total of 4, something like that. The type of mark. Offsets are going to be from the bleed area. So depending on how you want to have this set. And again, let's say those are my settings. I'll click OK. Now I can have one for banner with grommets. So right there you start to see we can have these presets. The quick set can apply these conditions. And when I click OK, and I come into the rip here and I say open, I could select my file, choose the quick set that I want to use, and open. And now it's going to rip the file according to those quick set parameters, whatever we set in there. So the idea behind the quick set is to streamline, keep you consistent, keep you repeatable, and save you time. Now, doing things manually in Job Editor is also an option. We definitely could do things manually in Job Editor, but for something maybe like a certain registration mark or something to this effect, for us to come in and say open and open a file, I'll just go to default quick set, open in Job Editor at this point, bring the file in, okay, my Job Editor software is going to launch. And now if I said, well, I need registration marks on this, I would go to my finishing tab, I'd go to my marks tab, I turn on registration marks, then I'd submit it. So you're telling me every single job I have to open Job Editor, go to the finishing tab, go to the marks tab, click on the button, and then submit? Well, no, not at all. We can make a quick set. Configure printer. Yes, I'm not ripping or printing. New quick set, or maybe even in the default, go into your advanced button, go to marks, turn on registration marks. Now I know some people who have kind of one standard setting that they apply to when they print, and they do that in the default quick set, and that's all they use is a default quick set that has like registration marks and a label and whatever else they're doing, and that's a standard thing they're doing. But I know a lot of other people who are coming in here and making up different quick sets to do many other things that they need to. So we can go into this main part of the software, quick sets tab, make a new quick set, save it, then we can use that quick set time and time again. When we rip a file with open, we can select a certain file. This time I'll turn off open in Job Editor. I can select that quick set, hit open, and bring the file into process. And again, that's saving me time. I don't have to go to Job Editor. The parameters, the settings are being applied. If I go to Job Editor, maybe I forget to do all the things I need to do. So this way keeps me consistent, keeps me repeatable, reliable. Everything's the same. Now let's talk about getting into Job Editor and some of the other features of Quick Sets. In version 12, we enabled some functionality relating to Quick Sets within Job Editor. So I'm going to open up a file into Job Editor, and I'm going to use my default quick set in this case, open in Job Editor. I opened in Job Editor. I used the default quick set. At this point, I'm sitting here and I'm reviewing my information about this account, and I say, oh, this was supposed to be a full canvas wrap. I should have said open and use the quick set full canvas wrap. Well, one feature in version 12 now is that I can go into file, apply quick set, and I can say full canvas wrap. And when I hit apply, it's going to re-rip the file and process and reflect. There's my 1-inch bleed, and here's my additional 2 inches of my trim size. So you can always go into File, Apply Quick Set, and apply some type of condition. Here's the one with the grommets. File, Apply Quick Set. I'll go back to default. In the past, if I brought this file into Job Editor and I forgot to select my quick set, I could either do everything manually here or I could cancel and then do it again, right? That's my choices. But now we have this new feature in version 12, which is Apply Quick Set. Very nice, very friendly. We're interacting with our quick sets, and we can kind of alter and set things up as we need to, apply the conditions we need to, the presets. All right, talking about the finishing tab here. I open this file into Job Editor to take a different twist on those quick sets. Yes, I can go to Configure Printer, I can go into my Quick Set tab and go to New and create new settings. But here in Job Editor, if I'm doing my regular work and I go to my Finishing tab, here's my bleed. So now talking about what we were having a little conversation about a moment ago, enabling the bleed. I want a 1-inch bleed. Okay, that bleed is going to be a mirror or pixel duplication. or a color. Color defaults to white, or I can say first pixel in the subject matter, or I can say custom and type in some numbers. For example, 100 magenta, there's my color for my bleed. So this shows you that bleed area. Or I can use this eyedropper, click on the eyedropper, and sample a color in my image. Now this is a one at a time setting. Click on the eyedropper, sample a color. Click on the eyedropper, sample a color. So in some programs, you have an eyedropper where you can continuously click. In this application, you're clicking on the eyedropper and then picking the color. For whatever reason, that's not the color you'd like to see, click on the eyedropper again, sample a new color. So we can control the bleed type. I'm going to let this stay at color for visual purposes so it's very easy and clear to see. That trim box command there, that's going to be additional media space beyond the bleed. So if I tell this to be an additional 1 inch, I now see just white, just blank, no printing, just media. So if I'm truly printing this on a canvas material, I don't need to print in this space. Here's my main front image of the sunflower, my main front part of the image, which is the facing part I see in my canvas wrap. Here's my color bleed along the sides. So as people walk past this canvas wrap and they see the edge, perhaps if it's exposed, they see the edge, they see this color. And then beyond that, behind the frame that I'm wrapping this to, would just be plain media. No need to print there. It's going to be the part that goes against the wall. Okay, now does that help? It's a visual. Does that help out?
Definitely.
Okay, good. Now, let's say that we like what we see here. We're going with this real simple canvas wrap. As far as the marks go, I could put on a top, bottom, left, and right mark. You'll notice these are defaulting to print only in the trim and the bleed, and not through the image. I don't think we'd really want that mark on the front part. We may not even want it in the bleed per se, but just to say, we wouldn't want it on the very face value of the sunflower image in our canvas wrap. But being said that, we can still make changes. This gear right here is going to let us control our bleed marks style. So here I can come in here and say, include this in the image, please. And now you see it going through the image. I'm going to turn that back off. The type of marks we can have a solid line that's 1, 2, 4, 8, or 16 pixels thick, and is either black or white. Now I turned off in the image area, so we're just going to see that in the trim and the bleed. There's my solid line black. Here's my solid line white. Depending on your image, solid line black or white, dotted line black or white, may be hard to see, or maybe easy to see in some areas, but not easy in others, depending on the subject matter. This is pretty much a consistent color here, so it's easy to see. But if I had some different varying tones, it might be difficult to see. So we can choose alternative. Now this is going to be black, white, black, white, black, white, repeating. We can control the line length and the gap or the space, and we still have our 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16 pixel thickness. But this alternates black, white, black, white, black, white, and now that might be the easiest to see overall, just depending on what your needs are. So we can always control the marks style, how we're going to print that, and where is it going to print. Now, here's another feature of our quicksets in version 12. We just saw apply quickset. Once we do some work in our file, let's say I do all this manually as I've done, I look at this and I say, this would make a nice quickset. I could go back into my RIP, configure printer, and create a new quick set. And maybe I will remember all these settings, maybe I will. But what I can do is right here while I'm in Job Editor, and it's all live, ready to go, I can go to File, and I can say Export as Quick Set. So Export as Quick Set is going to let me save what I've done here so far. It's going to let me push this out as a quick set parameter. Then I'm going to go to my RIP and import it as a quick set and have it in my list. this menu comes up and it's just showing us additional settings, additional things that I can apply, maybe hold for operator, maybe rotate or mirror. Notice this message in red, color correction filters will not be applied. This is one area that's not part of our build and saving out as exported as a quick set. So that's something that's a different process that we would do manually. We will take a look at that when we get into our advanced job editor series of our sessions. For now, I'm not going to add any additional features here. I'm just going to save this. When I go to save this, I've already made a folder within my samples folder of my RIP. I named that My Exported Quick Sets, so I use that for demonstration purposes. And now I'm going to name this quick set. Instead of naming this quick set the name of the file, Sunflower, I'm going to give it a name what's going to be appropriate to explain it. So I might say something like 1-inch canvas wrap. I'll hit save. This is still here in the file. I just took out those parameters and saved them as a quick set, a .ont file extension. I'm finished with my work here, so I'll go to print and submit this. Now that comes into my ripping processes, and it's ready to go. So if I double click it, I see my job properties, and I get a little bigger preview, and I can see there is my file right there. So what about that exported quick set? Well, let's bring it into our quick sets menu. I'll go to configure printer, stop my processing because I'm not ripping or printing, and here I will do import. I will browse to my directory, so give me a moment here to browse. So I've saved my exported quick set in my RIP folder in a folder called samples, and then I have a folder called my exported quick sets, and here it is, 1-inch canvas wrap. I'll open that up, and now I have it here. So earlier I made one in quick sets, new full canvas wrap. This time I created one in my job editor and said export as quick set. And now I have that here. I have to import it, of course, and bring it in. But now I would use that time and time again. Just as we saw, bringing in my file, I'll make my selection of a file here. I'll pick that quick set, 1-inch canvas wrap. No need for me to go to job editor. I don't have to do anything manually to the file. I just have to apply those conditions and hit open. It's going to rip and apply that 1-inch canvas wrap to that ocean. And you'll notice it kept the color information that I sampled, whatever parameters are there, keeps that data. That's the information. I sampled the color. I could have said mirror bleed, pixel duplication, whatever that bleed is set to, it will apply that. So within our quick sets, the purpose of these are to save us some time, make us efficient, keep us repeatable and reliable. If every time I opened up a file and I went into job editor, I'll go back to default, and I had to perform the grommets or perform the bleed or perform all these things manually, if I had to do that, it would take more time in the process, plus human error. I'm only human, and I might forget to turn on or turn off a certain setting. So if I have a quick set, it's going to keep me consistent. It's also going to save me time from having to do those things manually, and that's the idea behind the quick set. All right, one other feature that we have, a function, a sidebar to the quick set. Whenever we create a quick set, I created these quick sets. Whenever we create a quick set, it's automatically going to create a hot folder. If I delete these quick sets, the hot folder is deleted. It's self-managed within our program, okay? So when I make a quick set, a hot folder is created. Let's take a look at where these hot folders reside. I'm going to go to my folder structure, so let me go ahead and minimize the program. So I can see in my RIP is installed on my C drive, my ThriveRIP software. I'll have a folder here named Input. Inside Input, for that printer model that we're working with, here are those quick sets. If I open up 1-inch canvas wrap, this area right here where I'm expanding this drag box, right here, this is where I place my file to be ripped based on 1-inch canvas wrap quick set parameters. So I would take a file, In this case, I'm going to copy and paste it. When I do, that file is going to go into the 1-inch Canvas Wrap Hot folder, which is a quick set, process the data, bring it into the RIP, and process according to 1-inch Canvas Wrap. So I'm going to paste. That's there. I'm going to go to my RIP and scroll down to my list, and here's my file processing based on those parameters. So those hot folders can be shared across your network. And someone in design or desktop or customer service rep or whoever from a Macintosh or a PC, they can have these shares as shortcuts on their desktop, and they can drag and drop or copy and paste files into these hot folders. They're immediately going to come into the RIP software, process, and be ready to go. So this is how the QuickSet and hot folder relationship works. Now we have a way of our design team to send files to us remotely. Every printer is going to have its own series of QuickSets. Here's my Canon 8400, different QuickSet names. So you would specify and select that printer model. This is where I have to print my job to. Okay, what are the QuickSets for that printer? You'll notice when I copied and pasted or dragged and dropped into my 1-inch Canvas Wrap hot folder, the file was here for a moment and then it left the queue. That is because the hot folder processes the data just as our RIP processes the data of the QuickSet, processes the information, and moves it to the work directory. So in the end, my hot folders are empty. They're flushed because the processing has taken place. All right, so I'm going to pause here for a moment and see if you guys have any questions.
No, not at this time.
Okay. So keep this in mind. QuickSets can really be handy. Hot folders can be really handy. It all depends on how a company is set up to work, how they prefer to work. Do you want to share these across our network and have the desktop team pre-flight the file, write the file, and then place it into these hot folders, which in turn will come up into our RIP queue, and we'll have all of our jobs populating in this list, and then the RIP operator could be here and manage this information and print the jobs and work them through and change the media and go on and continue to work? Or would you rather have... Oh, sure, go ahead.
You'd
have to go in here and just set up, you do your sharing setup. Yeah. Share with advanced sharing. Yeah. And share that out. Exactly. Yep. You got it.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Sure. No problem. So again, we can also work where the operator at the RIP brings in files manually, makes the selection of the files, selects whatever QuickSet is supposed to be processed for, and from there, choose the one with the media type, specific media types, choose it with a certain category effect, whatever we need to do. Again, maybe no need to go to Job Editor. I mean, we can still apply a QuickSet and go into Job Editor, see the work in a larger scope. Let me show you that. You know, see my effects, see my changes. Now, this is me picking my durable backlit film. You can see here on the left, durable backlit film. And then from here, print and submit. So sure, I can see it as a bigger area, view it in a bigger sense, and then submit this on to my RIP. There may be no need to go into Job Editor at this point. We can save our steps by selecting a particular file in our list. No need to go to Job Editor. Just pick our effect that we want to apply and bring it into the RIP. So that's the benefit. We're automating our process. We're also keeping ourselves consistent because the QuickSet parameters has the file conditions saved to it. And that doesn't change until somebody goes in and edits that data. Now these QuickSets, if a customer is going to go through and set up a series of QuickSets, it would benefit them to export them out and save them out as a series of processes. And then if they ever needed to go back in and re-import, Perhaps somebody's gone through and made changes and they want to import. So they can always import this information again if they need to. And again, quicksets are specific to the printer. Every printer model will have different quicksets associated with it. And we always start out with a default. There's always a default quickset. And again, from there we can go through and create new quicksets. Or maybe simply just alter the default. If there's one standard setting of applications we need to apply, we can just have one standard default quickset and use that. And that's everything on our quicksets. So that's not to say there's not a reason to go into Job Editor. There still may be times you want to do something manually and you're setting things up, but then you have that availability or that option to export as a quickset and then come back into Configure Printer. Our first tab is our quickset tab, and import that exported quickset. So you still have that capability to do that and streamline your processing. Okay, are there any questions?
Nope, not for me.
All right, very good. And this will conclude our presentation on Achieve Automation with Quicksets. Thank you.
Thank you.